Hello and welcome to another Lost Caverns of Ixalan draft. I think this is now probably going to be my 7th video, my 9th draft overall. So I've been enjoying the format, but things I'm hearing make me not want to keep going back to it. This is an interesting pack. I think the best card is probably a black card, and I've heard that black is the worst color. It's this bat. Bat's really good. Guidewing, also really good. I think Riddle is quite a good blue card. The rare, no longer banned, but still not good. Spider is good in green-black, and that's it. We got some Land Cyclers, Wailing Pirate, Iceberg. I'm going to start by taking... I don't know if Riddle is better than Iceberg. I want to force white. I don't want to start with black, so let's start with Confounding Riddle, I think, here. Another Riddle. There's also a Guide Mural. Rare has been taken. There's also a Frog. Look at that little guy. So freaking cute. Kutsil. Also a good card. Green-white is not a high synergy archetype, but it is a high win rate archetype. We're not having any synergy. Also some Dismantlers. Maybe these will come back. You can just play like a controlling blue-white deck. I think that's what I'm leaning towards here. Take the Guide Mural, go controlling blue-white. Otherwise I could take like the Frog. Or a second Riddle would be keep me the most open. Take the Mural. I haven't played with this card that much yet. But it seems like a very good one. Okay, this is an easy pick now. The best blue common, and possibly the best common in the set, is right here. There's also a Hammer, Twists and Turns, Suspicious Clips, which is a sideboard card. Final Strike is pretty good. Dynamiton has kicked my butt in some of the aggressive decks. We're just gonna happily take this Waterwind Scout. What are we hoping to get back out of this pack? Wailing Pirates, maybe Iceberg. Yeah. I mean, to play Companion, maybe even Foundry in this deck. Okay, interesting. So there's a Waterlogged Hulk. Goes really well in a blue Descend deck, but it's also an artifact and it flips into a win condition. Also a Deadweight. Deadweight. Doesn't Superman make me go. I mean, it's notable, but doesn't Superman make me go black yet? I don't think I'll. From what I've experienced, and mostly what I've heard, podcasts and stuff, it's like you don't want to go black unless you have the rares. And I think that's probably reasonable. I like Waterlogged Hulk, though. You play it on turn one, it's pretty great. Play it later, it can still flip into a very big threat. Okay, so now there's a Spike Tail, a Monstrous. Wow, three Land Cyclers. Osmium Blast go pretty well in our blue-white deck. Sandwing, I think, goes pretty well in blue-white, too. So Volcano. I think I'm just going to take the Sandwing here. I have Hulk. Don't have that many ways to mill. No, I'm just taking the Sandwing. Or the Blast. Ooh, Defossilize. Okay, that's a really good black card. There's also a Brackish Blunder, which is probably what I'm going to take. White doesn't look like it's that open, but blue feels open, but maybe that's just because it's the deepest color. I do like these black cards. I could see making a blue-black Descend deck out of this, but... I'm just gonna stick with Blackish Blunder for now. Here. Oh wow, Aqualung. Radiant Sun's Creation. Rock Slide. Huh. Don't think I'm gonna get into Aqualung with all these blue cards. Curator is interesting. I don't have any ways to discover yet. And Blue Red is not really into that kind of thing. I'm just gonna take. Really want Sage of Days. really like that card. Yeah, I'll take Curator. I'm probably not gonna play it, but I'll take it. Okay. Cash. Gold Digger. Ceratops. The Millennium Calendar. Would I play this? I probably don't want to play any of these other cards. I mean, it could be a win condition. It seems like a very bad one, though. Okay, so all the white cards are gone. That's not very surprising. Iceberg is taken, but Wailing Pirates is still here. All the red cards are also still here. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. I think we're probably going to be going blue-red. Deep. Don't want green cards, really. Okay. There's some black cards here. I don't hate, but Venomton would be great. Wow, that's super late dead weight. I don't really want any of these other cards in red, so take it here. Shift over. Oh. And Shaft Spider. Take that uncommon. Okay. Where are we going from here? Okay, there's a Saw Blades, which would be great in blue whites. There's... don't care about that. Probably don't care about that. Hat, bright thing. Plundering Pirates, probably the best card for blue-red. I think I'll just take the Saw Blades. Saw Blades is like the perfect card in a like defensive blue-white deck. But, I mean, white wasn't really open last pack. Red was, but... there's probably another blue-red player at the table. I'm still going to take the Saw Blades. I think I can get enough blue. I can just fill in whatever color I want. Probably. Okay, there's a Militia. I like Militia. Sunbird Standard. That could be interesting. There's no good blue cards here. A Captivate Cave. I kind of want to take the Militia or the Standard. I'm going to lean towards the Standard. Leans us towards like a multicolor deck. But currently we don't really want, not really splashing anything. But could be. Runner, I like that. Tully's Favor. Cloud Guard. Okay, now we're seeing good white cards. I'm just gonna take the Dawn Runner here. Cloud Guard is awesome. Well, it makes an artifact, so probably better in a God Mural deck. Aspirant, another Dynamiton, a Compass Gnome. I wonder if we're just supposed to get out of. I mean, it felt like blue was open, but. Only one blue card was taken out of this pack. That's the one we took. I think for now, I'm just gonna take the Compass Gnome. I think there's a chance we could pivot to white red. Okay, there's a Guidewing, Self-Reflection, all those Lavatons. Yep, we can't go red black now. Bat Colony. Do torch, iceberg. Yeah, torch would be good. We're going aggressive. Just gonna take the iceberg off. Okay. Still don't feel too bad about being blue bite right now. Okay, puzzle door is nice. Scantil, that's really late. But we don't really have any ways to explore besides this. Maybe this. Just like puzzle door. Thing, blowgun, rare, 2-4, spelunking, 2-4's not very good. Out of here. Out of here could be pretty good in this deck. We've got right. Sanguine Evangelist. Not exactly a control card, but just huge. Huge with its how good its rate is. Like 2-1, makes it 1-1, and it dies into another one, and it has Battlecraft, so it allows us to get really some really aggressive starts. Yeah, definitely gonna take the advantages. I can. Probably no reason to play the standard unless we really find something we want to splash. There's an Abrade. I don't think I need to splash Abrade though. A lot of good red cards here. Abrade, Yearling, Ire, Idol. No land. Speaking of lands, I would like to see hidden lands for this deck. Sentry. Unlucky drop. Oh, there's one. I think I'm gonna take the sentry though. I need more two drops. Obelisk, Chariot, Blunder, Pup. Pup is awesome with saw blades. Let's hold up our mana. That's gonna be pretty great. I do want Nautilus also. Chariot Course is just a great card. Oh, why you do this to me? Why? Okay, there's all the gold cards that we could have wanted. I splashed Captain Storm. Three pirates, six artifacts. It's better to splash Sunborn. Or just take another water hold. And I don't think I'm done with fixing. A Dismantler seems like a good card. Just a 1/4 that can destroy artifacts. Close down artifact decks a little bit. It's also a Cosmic Impulse, but... Ooh. Shit. What are my types? Three pirates, one vampire, could play some dinosaurs. What am I gonna be missing? Merfolk? I have a Merfolk. Wait, I can make this work, can't I? You got blue light? Can I actually make this work? Holy shit. People will always underestimate this card. Wonder Bartolome. There's another vampire. It's not a very good vampire. What is the vampire I have right now? That one? It's a good one. Six blunder. Human. Another merfolk. I have two merfolk currently. This is 2/4. I can do some stuff. Okay, Nautilus, I like that. Pirate hat. Maybe. It's another vampire. Okay, okay. Why did I think blue-white can't do it? Okay, so I currently just have the one dinosaur, right? Yeah, just the one. I can play this one, and it can get me red, but it doesn't really splash. I can also possibly splash black, if that's bad, too. I'm gonna try and make do with just one vampire. Three pirates, one dinosaur, three merfolk. Oh, I didn't get
a cave.
I don't think I need the calendar. I have throne, I have hulks. Flashed up. What is? Yeah, there was something I didn't take over the second blunder. Only three pirates, I don't want the hat. And then what? A couple ways to explore, but I think a 2/4 is not that bad. Maybe I don't need it. I wanna play all this stuff. Doesn't look good. Yeah, I still think this is good. It mills us, it's an artifact, it turns into a wind condition. Okay, I don't really love that I only have one vampire and one dinosaur. I'm gonna try it like that. Okay. Are we cutting a thing? Yeah, maybe I do just cut a 2/4 here. Could cut the Maya guiding too. It's not really a deck that's gonna win one damage in the air at a time. It does, it's because of this guide wing. Diver. Play like this. Pick up my deck. Yeah. Light control. Let's go. I haven't drafted this fire type yet. It's exciting. I think I want to get this going before this. Blue white mirror, but they have a courtyard. Their control of these saw blades is not going to be that great. God knows it can be great though. Okay. It's not very good against. I don't really have many answers to that. Got a pirate now. I got this pirate in my hand. I just played. I mean, my own iceberg doesn't trade with that. I still think I'm just playing this, attacking. End this up, maybe. Not if they don't play a creature, though. Cosmic Blast, okay. I milled the dinosaur. I had the vampire in my hand. I just need to find a merfolk now. I have two of those. If I don't draw a fifth land, turn's not going to be that great. Hopefully I can cast this. I guess casting this is okay. Use mill two lands. Guess I'll just play that. Probably stop milling myself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. When I get to send 8 slash and I have a merfolk. Anyone cards. As soon as I find a merfolk, it's on. This can also help me turn this on. Did I hold up Whirlpool or something? Okay. Gone to my bat. Love that for me. Still no Murpho. Okay, I got a pup. Missing land drops though. That's again. If we find a Murpho, then we can craft. Oop. How many lands are left in my deck? 7? 16 cards. Okay. I'm probably just gonna pop that. Maybe I won't. Maybe I just pop the iceberg. I can craft that. I won't get a bat though. I wanna make them deal with this. can craft their iceberg, but they have to use the needle to do it because I have nothing in their graveyard. Draw a card, so I think I'm gonna bounce the iceberg with this pup. If it resolves. Maybe I stop playing. I only have 15 cards. This is gonna put me down 2 more cards. Still no more folks. This guy's 4 to craft. Yeah, it feels like I'm the beat down here. That's kind of sucky for my puppy. But he already gave me value, so it's fine. Okay, so I can guide Mural next turn. Oops, so much. Still didn't find a merfolk. Cut guard. Okay. They're gonna craft the needle with the gnome? They are. Okay. Okay, there's the merfolk. It explores too. I'm gonna draw this next turn. It's just mostly just didn't want to put in the graveyard. Oh, example. Okay. I think this has facts. Okay. So this gets to attack next turn, that's cool. That's battle cry. You got rid of the whirlpool. Interesting. I mean, they're gonna craft the
iceberg there? Oh, they're whirlpooling.
Wait, that's a problem. That's my only vampire. But they don't know that. I guess that's a problem with that being my only vampire. Okay. Okay. Well, now I do this. Dang, they exiled my one vampire. That's pretty good for them. That's a 4-6. Petrify. Okay. Guess I'm playing this next turn. I hope they still petrify my throne, because I don't know that's my last, my only vampire. Maybe they will know, because I stopped milling, but also stopped milling for other reasons. Alright, I want to use... I want them to petrify... I don't want them to petrify the iceberg until, or, yeah. I don't want to flip the iceberg because they could just petrify. They can flip their own iceberg. I flip mine, and then petrify mine. And that's a problem. Go ahead, petrify. Mantler. That is really annoying. That just blows up everything. I mean, that blows up their iceberg and their compass and my Nautilus. And my saw blades, yeah, that one dismantler ruins everything. I got 6, I got 4. What's my best draw now? Waterlogged Hulk, probably. Waterwind Scout's still pretty good. And a value X. Oh yeah, with 5 mana they can blow up so many 2 mana artifacts. Oh, they have some blades. Gross. Am I gonna get decked?
Not if I get this. If I can get
them to blow this up and then draw this Hulk, then I think I'm okay. Okay, there we go. There they go. Yep. Riddle. Yikes. Riddle mills me 4. I think I still am supposed to do it though. Maybe not actually. I can probably still counter something. They're gonna start sacrificing capes. I can go wherever this is, if I care. Okay. Island is not what I wanted. That really sucks. Then I'm exiling my vampire. Huge problem. Answer to 5/7 flyer. No. I just need to find this Hulk before time runs out. I only have 7 turns. Oh, they're attacking now. That's kind of scary. So I'll let them kill one of these with their blades. That's gonna turn to a 5/5 though. Kind of a problem. If Hulk is my next card, maybe there's still hope for me. Okay, I have a lot of artifacts in the graveyard now. Sandwing was such a good play for them. Like, it gained them 3 life. It's bigger than any of my other creatures. Oh wow. Let's see. Okay. That's a good card. Alright. Hulk might not do it anymore. Island definitely doesn't do it. Wow. Do like three lands in a row here. Pretty annoying. Dang. Lose the mirror match. Because they have caves and they exiled my only vamp. Mostly because they exiled my only vamp. Right. I got lucky and that was my last one. Yeah. Water went scout. That's kind of interesting. That maybe gives me another turn. That was my last land. Okay. Well, they have like nothing left. 7, 8, 9, 10 lands. So they have like 7 lands in there, these 14 cards somewhere. Chump block with flyer. Play Hulk. Chump block with another flyer. Maybe they'll leave this back now. Then I can win. I draw a puzzle door, that's like the worst possible draw. Yeah. Sentry doesn't really do anything either. And force me to jump now. Okay. Oh, they're attacking the slot bullets. I just want to chomp here. And they're actually a little bit close to death. Okay, well. Two ground blockers. They didn't attack me with their flyer. That's good for me. I guess they can craft, and then they still get to discover. And then they can crew with the Sunscribe. Scribe one. Yeah, they're probably gonna craft here. To discover, oh, clarifier bricks. That's really bad for me. I think that beats me now, for sure. Crap. Yeah. Now that they're at 6, I need to top deck Hulk, like, now. I'm also kind of just dead. Oh, puzzle door. Just the card I was not hoping to see. Alright, now we're dead. Dang it! Well, Throne would have been amazing if they didn't exile my only vampire. Just like I said. Yeah, that big flyer was huge too. Super important for them. Okay, I like this hand. Ooh. Yes, please. Can we borrow? Alright, I'm milling myself. don't want to use saw blades on Capybara. Oh, it's a 1-3. No way. Oh. Oh. That's fucking huge. Take the Nautilus. Okay, so I can bounce that. Okay, so what am I doing here? Nautilus can block. I guess that's probably the play. Currently have 3 permanents. Alright, they don't have a dinosaur. Which means that has to be for 6. Okay, there's the throne. Let's play the throne. Got the dinosaur in our hand. That's still tapped. Might plunder it and turn. Okay, go to 12. Cloud. Alright. Mill 2. 1. I've got a pirate in the grave. I think I'm island cycling this dinosaur. I've got pirate dinosaur now. No more Forker Vampire yet. Petrify my throne. God damn it. Everyone keeps petrifying my shit. haunted the land. Okay. Oh, the pup can bounce the throne. But I still need to... Oh, they're just going all in on the guy. That sucks. I can't do anything about that, actually. Okay. That's gonna kill me. Okay, there's my vampire. I'm just dead to this guide wing though. Damn it. I guess my out is I mill a merfolk. It did. Maybe they attack with more than just that. They need this pair. One turn too late. Possible I could have played the pup earlier and bounced it down. I don't know. Yeah, I'm just dead if they attack me with the guide, just the guide wing, and I die. Well, attack me with the capybara too. Just press attack all, opponent. No! Dang it! Hey, that's too bad. Oh, we didn't get a pick. Flip the throne, but it was too late. And we are 0-2 right now. It's really sad. It would be nice to have a whirlpool for this deck. Really struggle to kill things with vigilance or... This is a good hand. Hulk, Sentry, Iceberg. We are on the draw though, which is booby. Probably not an aggressive deck though. We haven't flipped any of these yet either. Would have been awesome in that first game that we lost though. We like drew one. They could have out of air. Definitely went out of air with iceberg. I don't think I do. I don't really care if they counter this sentry anyway. So I can't. I would be able to attack with it next turn. Oh, they're just missing land rights. Sweet. That's great for us. I wanted to draw that. That would have been such a good draw, but we milled it first instead. Oh, shit, they hit a land drop? That's bad. Did I mill an island? I did. Okay. So I could craft this so that this could attack. be the best thing I can do right now. No tie binder. Fuck you. Wow. Okay. They had their air that blows me out there. That might have been better for them. Next turn. This is gonna be bigger. A bigger deal. They have one too. Interesting. Oh. Also very interesting. Okay, another blue white matchup. I don't have anything to craft there, so I start now. Abuelo! Okay. Interesting. Abuelo is really interesting there. I don't really have anything to craft this with right now. Except one of these. It's pretty annoying, actually. Oh. I think that's fine, though. Plus 3, stack my sides. Huh. A boiler blinking mat is kind of bad for me, but it's not that bad. I can do this. And then this. And now I have this dismantler. Then the Waylo doesn't get them out of this problem. They also alright, so an artifact at the top lets both of these sentries attack. Alternatively, I can just craft. But I have to craft, like, the token. Tinkerer's Tower. Interesting. Haha! Get dismantled. Yep, plonk. I could probably just force them to jump off of the Boilo here. What's that gonna do? I just countered it. So I definitely have to jump off the Boilo. Oh, I needed to maybe not tap that Plains. I'm going to pass. I probably just blow up all the artifact tokens. Oh, but I wanted to craft first. If I draw planes, I can do both. If I draw land, I can do both. Scout. Let's just go to combat for no, let's not go to combat first. Let's they can gain three with Tote, and they can make a llama. Oh, pup. Pup bound mural? Okay, so they can gain three life. Block, take four. Yep. I could be like making 2/4/4s here by untapping this, but that's kind of ridiculous. I could just kill them. Ah, we won one. Alright, so far we played against blue white, and okay. Like this hand a lot, actually. Don't love that we're on the draw. We Hulk. Which we did craft the Hulk, but we got owned by a Tidebinder. A rare last game. Another blue deck. Another blue-white deck. Beacon Hammer. They're probably an aggressive blue-white deck then. Dismantler is kind of interesting here.
I don't just want to hit my land drops though.
So, just gonna play the door. Merfolk in my graveyard now. So I've got pop. Counterspell plus pop. Seems good. Yeah, I see a counterspell, I think. And then I'll play my one graveyard. One, two, three, four. Ascended four. Great. It's a good card. Really good card. Don't want to make this trade. Just Cosmium Blast, but then that means that they get to explore here. Oh wait, this could be a problem. Attacking with a gnome here is kind of bad. Well. Now if they get a non-land on top, I lose my gnome. Yep. Bye gnome. Let me. Oh. They didn't. Oh, because they already blocked. Yeah. It's fine. I don't want to miss a land drop here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Flipping. Okay, I can just saw blades the shit out of that. You're gonna blow up my Hulk? Okay, I can bounce out with Hog if I want. Okay, move my Vamp. Oh. I see. Okay. That's pretty good value. one. I'm one off because I exiled. Fine. I can get one more permanent in my graveyard. Plus, like, Wolfer doesn't block me right now. I wonder if I want to trade. I think so. No, I don't think so. Actually, I could just put this in the room. Plus I have pup I can use. 7. If they use that, I'll probably just pup it. Well, they also don't have anything that they can craft with, except hammer. So that means they want to probably want to sacrifice the hammer even more. It's the plan, dog. I should take it. Okay. Ah, shit. Don't do that. That sucks. Ah. I'm using this thing with six toughness again. Okay, how do I deal with that? I need, like, none of that deals with this. I can attack for 10. That's not enough. Dying to 4-6 Sandwing again. Frickin' A. Bummer. Okay. Well, that's the end of that draft. Let's do a little bit of a review. What are we? 2-3? 1-3. Even worse. Throne was good, even though we got it really late. Didn't really realize that this color combination could get there until we saw it, and I'm like, oh, right. This color combination does have all the types, but you have to play land cycling dinosaurs, which is fine. This was a little bit crafting, like, turning it on was a little bit too slow against one opponent who kind of went all in the air. I think what we really needed was more interaction. We had Blast and Saw Blades and like Counterspell and Bounce, but we had no hard answers to creatures with six toughness, which ended up being kind of our downfall. Like twice those stupid, like a Sandwing with 1+1+1 ended up killing us two of those three games, or two of those three losses. Guide Mural was great. Riddle felt really good. Iceberg and Hulks felt really good. Dismantler felt awesome. Evangelist just is awesome. I don't know about Out of Air, but I would have liked to see some, like, Quicksand Whirlpools. That seems pretty important in a blue-white control deck. Like, hard removal is... Not having hard removal for their flyers, whether they're, like, a Vigilant Flyer and we had this, or a 6 toughness flyer, was a huge problem and lost us two of our games. Thank you all for watching. I will see you next time, and if you're watching on Twitch, we're going to do one more draft and be done, because I don't have to work early. If you're watching on YouTube, put hashtag 6 is a magic number in the comments, along with some feedback, and you'll be entered to win a booster box. I'd love to see people watching until the end and subscribing on YouTube. Those are the biggest things for me, so I can start getting paid by YouTube. Also, I'd like to see people at least doing like the free minimum stuff, like liking, commenting, subscribing on YouTube. That's all free, of course. Then there's following on Twitch. Subscribing with Prime Gaming, that's free once per month to do that, or just $5 to subscribe. Thanks for everyone for your support. You're all awesome. Love you. Bye.